Hello and welcome to the 2014 Veterans Day program sponsored by the class of 2022, the current fifth graders at Northwest Lawrence. Our students have worked very hard and they are very proud to present this program to you. We do this because we understand that it is important and necessary to teach children to respect that our freedom is not free, that there is a price. And we salute all of those who have served our country in the United States Armed Forces. At this time, I'd like to welcome Hudson Smith to the stage to begin our program.
Please bow your heads for a prayer. Dear God, thank you for allowing us to present this program in honor of our veterans. Please bless the students, teachers, parents, and everyone who helped with putting this program together. Please watch over us as we go back to our schools, homes, and workplaces after this program. In your name I pray, amen.
Thank you. welcome you today. Our veterans, parents, faculty, and fellow students to our 20th annual Veterans Day celebration. The program has evolved over the years, and many of the participants will never forget their involvement. However, our purpose has not changed. We are here today to honor our country's veterans and to showcase patriotism and our great country.
Please stand as we present the flags of the United States of America. Remain standing and join with us as we pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
They did their share.
On Veterans Day, we honor soldiers who protect our nation.
For their service as our warriors, they deserve our admiration. Some of them were drafted.
Some of these were volunteers.
For some, it was just yesterday.
For some, it's been many years.
In the jungle or the desert.
On land or on the sea.
They did whatever was assigned.
To produce a victory.
Some came back, some didn't. They defended us everywhere.
Some saw combat, some rode a desk. All of them did their share. No matter what the duty, for low pay and little glory, these soldiers gave up normal lives for duties mundane and gory.
Let every veteran be honored. Don't let politics get in the way. Without them, freedom would have died. What they did, we can't repay.
We owe so much to them.
Who kept us safe from terror.
So when we see a uniform,
let's say thank you to every wearer.
Since September 11th, 2001, being thankful for our lives and where we live has become more important than ever. We must stand together and hold fast to the belief that God will bless America. country that has learned from our forefathers and stand proud to be the recipients of the freedom that they so boldly fought for. Many more important symbols and forefathers molded our country into the nation that it is today.
Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free, the wretched refuse of your teeming shore. Send these, the homeless, the tempest, tossed to me. I lift my lamp beside the golden door.
Ah, George Washington had no desire to be the first president of our new nation in 1789. However, the American people had other ideas. They wanted a strong national leader with great authority to be their first president. I am now considered to be the father of our great nation.
Four score and 7 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent a new nation, conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal. I was the author of this unforgettable speech. Before the war, people said, "The United States are." After my speech, they said, "The United States is." In other words, I helped them realize that we were not just a collection of individual states, but one single nation. We are one.
I, Betsy Ross, recommended a 5-point star for our new country and flag. However, the committee protested it was far too difficult to make. I simply fold a piece of paper just like this, and with a single snip of my scissors, produced a symmetrical 5-point star. This flag, they then agreed, this flag has become a symbol of liberty, freedom, and pride. It now flies on the moon, sits atop Mount Everest, and is in most homes and public places. The flag is how America signs her name.
The American Red Cross. The Civil War gave me a chance for accomplishment as I searched for something to do. That was something. The women who went to the field, you say? The women who went to the field and prayed? What did they go for? Just to be in the way? They'd not know the difference betwixt work and play. What did they know about war anyway? What could they do? Of what use could they be? They would scream at the sight of a gun, don't you see? And these were the women who went to the war, the women of question. What did they go for? Because in their hearts, God planted a seed of pity for woe and help for its need.
December 7th, 1776. 1941, a date which will live in infamy. The United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. In the future day, which we seek to make secure, we look forward to a world founded upon four essential human freedoms. 1, the freedom of speech and expression everywhere in the world. 2, the freedom of every person to worship God in his own way. 3, freedom from wants. 4, freedom from fear. The only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
All the day long, whether rain or shine, I was a part of the assembly line. I was making history, working for victory. I am Rosie the Riveter. When they gave me a grade of E, I was proud as I could be. There's something true about being red, white, and blue. I am Rosie the Riveter.
Major Herndon Cummings. I was assigned to the 447th Bomber Group for 4 years as a Tuskegee Airman. I also enlisted for 20 years of additional service in the United States Air Force Reserves.
I am Colonel Man Rogers. I was a radio operator before attending flight school. I served in the 99th Fighter Squadron, Red Tails, as a Tuskegee Airman. I later worked for NASA as a program manager on the Apollo 13 mission.
I am Colonel John Wyatt. I was known as Mr. Death by my fellow pilots. I was the first African-American test pilot for the United States Air Force.
A state in our flag. We all work together for United We Stand. Today, we recognize each branch that has represented us so well. When a young person joins the armed force, becomes a member of the armed forces, they do not just join for a day, a year, or just 4 years. They are committed a lifetime of service to our country. Not only are we honoring those who fought, but also those veterans who were sacrificed as prisoners of war. Let us not forget these fallen heroes.
In 1918, on the 11th hour, on the 11th day of the 11th month, an agreement was signed which ended World War I, the war to end all wars. 3 years later, on November 11, 1921, our country the peace an unknown soldier from this war in a tomb in Eglinton National Cemetery. Honor Guard stands in a tree over this tomb to this day. Since 1921, November 11 has been set aside as a day of remembrance for those who fought and died for our freedom.
Takes a lot of courage to have to say goodbye, not knowing as you go to war if you will live or die. Many make this sacrifice and they fight to keep us free. They're doing it for each of us. They're doing it for me.
Thank you.
because of you, veterans, that we have this program. It is because of what you have done, and you are the reason we have the freedom we have today.
This is America, America.
To ask all of the veterans of the armed forces and servicemen and women that are currently serving to please stand. Heroes. Thank you for the sacrifices you have made to allow us to live in a free country.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I worked for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife, I thank the Lord above to be living here today, where the flag still stands for freedom,
and they can't take that away.
And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me.
And I'll gladly stand up next to you and defend us till today. Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, from New York to LA. Well, there's pride in every American's heart, and it's time we stand and say, the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I'll gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. There ain't no doubt.